tragedy, but if you don't laugh at any of the jokes, then it's just a tragedy. And then Maggie Knox would like to add that she's from the International Thespian Society. They wrapped with the actress next to her name. We just wanted to clarify that.
Also, because this interview is an issue, the word comatose means someone who's in a coma. That'll make sense.
We hope you enjoy the show.
Look at her rabbit. Her outfit. She Well, I guess I'm stuck with you for the next 97 hours.
Just stay out of my way, Colby.
And keep your name tag on. And don't tell anyone. Everyone's lost your phone, Apple. Come on, let's sit first. That's the crazy janitor. Stay away from him. There's a supply closet where you'll shed a lot of tears. Those are the patient rooms. You can sleep in the empty ones or with the comatose ones. But don't let Ollie catch you. Marley's cool though. The whole double personality thing's really great.
Did you just say sleep with the comatose ones?
Yeah, sure, kid. Whatever gets your free
on. When I was a kid, I used to be an atheist, but when I turned 30, I decided to eat meat again.
Come on, kid. God, modern technology is ruining the attention span of young moms.
Really?
My phone is for medical purposes? Come on, we really need to get started.
Excuse me, pardon me, I'm going to be late. Oh, this is a metaphor for life.
Bad day?
Mr. Ritz, you don't have any idea. I've been here all of an hour and I'm already head chair of three committees assisting on heart surgery and the alternate DJ for this year's Christmas dance, which is 7 months away.
It's a tough job. This hospital messes with your mind.
But other than my eventual and then chaotic destruction, how's your life going?
Funny that you asked. Me and Harry got in a fight earlier. We might have to duel him later.
That's great. Excuse me.
I used to drink paper mache until my grandma set herself on fire.
That's really nice. I'll just go this way. Mostly deaf patient in room 666. Right away, ma'am.
only steps away. And like game of checkers, I will checkmate my opponent.
Not to interrupt all that, but how do you know this wasn't just an accident?
Because the murderous choice of weapons seems to be the poetic beauty of death euphemisms.
What's euthanasia?
Euphemism.
That's what I said. Euthanasia.
You are a nurse. There is a very big difference between euphemism and euthanasia. And you should know that, okay? Anyway, at the first scene, there is evidence of an axe on the floor. Because somebody wanted him to trip, right? And now, someone sends this old lady flowers she's allergic to? I'll leave it. Please, everyone, just go back to work. Except you. You have the murder both times, correct?
Yes, but I swear, it wasn't me.
Okay, I did it. Now that I know you're trustworthy, though, and I need you to be my man on the inside.
The inside?
The inside.
Do you think it could be someone within the hospital doing this?
Oh, I know so. It could be that weird desk jockey or the head nurse of the marathon.
Maybe.
You're on the job, nurse. The fate of the United States of America rests in your hands. Contact me when you find anything interesting.
I don't think that's that. Has anyone seen my patient, 117?
Holly, I was once a local workman, trapped in a storm,
eventually relived the same freaking day.
And it was you who set me up to slide past the janitor.
Yeah, he did use a lot of puns. Like, figure it out. Dr. Middle, you are under arrest.
You can't arrest me on Lord Voldemort!
Oh, he's so judgmental.